What's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the most reliable source for professional VR camera reviews and tutorial. Today, we are starting a new tutorial series, how to create a breathtaking cinematic VR timelapse with consumer and professional VR camera. In this episode, we are going to use one of my favorite professional VR cameras, the Insta360 Pro 2 right here. We are going to break it down into two different workflows, the JPEG timelapse and the raw DNG timelapse workflow. The raw DNG timelapse requires Mystica VR to restitch, but it creates the best looking 16-bit color depth timelapse video that dramatically increases your production values. You can see some of my example here from my Kauai trip and Dubai trip. Yes, some of those are captured with the Insta360 Titan, but the Insta360 Titan workflow is identical to the Insta360 Pro 2. You just have two more lenses to stitch. By the way, if you want discount and free battery combo of the Insta360 Pro 2, click the link in the description below. JPEG vs. RAW DNG 360 timelapse. Understanding the risk and reward of choosing the correct timelapse approach is very important as a 360 filmmakers. Today, we focus on run and gun JPEG 360 timelapse. This requires precision during capture on location, but it saves lots of time and money in post-production compared to the RAW DNG capture. It allows you to do 2-second interval timelapse instead of a 4-second interval, which will save you lots of time to capture enough frames for a video timelapse. This is very important when time is limited on location. It does not allow lots of fixed in post options like denoising, blowout sky, or losing too much detail in shadow. So if you mess up with your exposure on set, the timelapse is ruined. So you cannot use Lightroom or Adobe Camera Raw to fix it. Again, look at the on-screen pros and cons comparison to decide if JPEG 360 timelapse is right for you on that particular location during pre-production. While talking about pre-production, please don't just show up on a location. Do some research using Google Maps 360 feature to find the right time and perfect spot to set up your camera. Camera setup. When you arrive on location, find a spot based on your Google Maps research. The spot should be safe and avoid tourists and traffic. Tourists are the worst enemy of any 360 timelapse because most of them never see a 360 camera. And the Insta360 Pro right here is a very cute camera. It looks like a robot and draws too much attention. Kawaii! Besides a safe location, the next very important thing of any 360 timelapse is stabilization. You want your tripod or monopod to be extremely stable and not affected by winds. A slight movement will destroy your timelapse, especially in VR headset. There is no warp stabilizer in 360 timelapse, and Mocha Pro is very expensive software. So don't rely on fix it in post mindset. Invest in a really good monopod with weight and sandbag in the base with professional grade build. I will highly recommend watching this video to get the exact monopod setup. If you have the monopod as I suggested, you can also get the camera higher than the crowd. It creates a vertical stitching distance, so even the tourists are walking too close to the camera, they still have a vertical distance to stitch them out in post-production. Monoscopic versus stereoscopic. If you are using Insta360 Pro 2 or Titan, you should always shoot in stereo 3D and decide in post which one you are going to use. Stereo 3D look amazing when you have cloud hitting the camera slowly like this one. When captured on top of Kalalau Mountain, the highest point of Kauai, so I highly recommend experiment stereoscopic 3D in timelapse and high up in your neighborhood mountains to capture some cloud movement in 3D. And don't worry about post-production because I will show you how to deal with 3D in post. Camera setting. Nail the correct camera settings is the most important part of creating a good JPEG 360 timelapse, as you cannot fix it in post. So the first rule of thumb, do not use auto exposure. If you create flicker, which is very hard to remove it in post unless you use LR timelapse in raw DNG following this tutorial. Also, do not use auto white balance as well. As you see the changing color of this timelapse, it is because of the auto white balance. So the first thing to decide is the white balance. Lock it 5000 Kelvin if it is bright daylight or 4000 Kelvin if it's sunset. Then set your ISO in 100. Yes, never go above 100 on Insta360 Pro 2 if you want to avoid noise and make the timelapse look cinematic. Not like video, you can always do long exposure timelapse in low light. As a matter of fact, I'm going to show you the setting in an extremely low light capture as you see right here. If you can nail long exposure night lab, bright daylight will be a piece of cake for you. So the only thing you need to worry is shutter speed. I love long exposure timelapse. Look at that nice light trail following all the moving cars at night. It looks so cinematic. I will teach you how to get the same effects even in bright daylight in high shutter speed later without ND filters. But to get the nice motion blur, it is to get your shutter speed slower than 1/5 seconds. This one is actually 1/2.5 seconds. But how do you know which shutter speed you should use on the location? Well, here is another tip for you. You test it on location. I will take a still 360 photo with the setting I guess, which start from 1/5 seconds. Then I look at the photo on my iPhone or iPad, scroll to each lens. If it is underexposed, I lower the shutter speed to 1/2.5 or 1 second. If it's overexposed, I will increase the shutter speed to 1/10 seconds. Take another photo and repeat the same process until you find the correct exposure. I do that in both JPEG and DNG timelapse. What if sunrise or sunset timelapse while lighting is changing by the minutes? Well, if you are doing lots of sunset and sunrise timelapse like I do, I will highly recommend doing DNG timelapse using Adobe Camera Raw, which will be the next tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Stitching 360 timelapse. Now we offload all the JPEG following this tutorial from your 360 camera, the Insta360 Pro 2 and or the Titan. We are going to stitch it using Insta360 Stitcher, which comes free with your camera. Content type, you choose monoscopic or stereoscopic based on your project. I always choose optical flow as I found best result compared to the new optical flow, which always have some strange artifacts. The rest, you can just leave it as default. Make sure you check gyroscopic stabilization if you are using the Insta360 Pro 2. But if you are using the Pro 1, please do not check this. This feature only works for Pro 2 and Titan, and it does help in a windy day. In Pro 1, it will shake your timelapse and backfire the result, so uncheck it. Another tip, please write it down. And then hit preview stitching effects to open calibration windows. In here, you are going to level your 360 timelapse if you fail to do so during capture. I found that even you level your camera, it is still not perfect, so you need to do so in this stage. Luckily, Insta360 make it extremely easy. First, go ahead and hit the Zenith optimization if you are indoor, but outdoor, don't use it. Hit the grid icon right here, turn on the grid. Find vertical lines in the frame like this LiPo right here and align it with the grid. I will change my center of focus as well in here to the famous monument in Sao Paulo, Brazil. Yes, I captured this in Brazil. The new 360 size and sound of Sao Paulo is coming out very soon. Now go ahead and hit save and apply. The result I use is 8K because I only do 8K 360 video, but change it according to your project size. Pick the output directory and then hit stitch now. Go and get a cup of coffee or go on Instagram and follow me on Instagram for the latest 360 inspiration or free giveaways. Okay, now we are done. Let's import the whole thing in the brand new Adobe Premiere 2020 to check it out. You can also use Final Cut Pro X or DaVinci Resolve. Deflicker, denoise, and add motion blur. Now we are in Adobe Premiere 2020. Double click your project window, open a folder of your timeline render, pick the number one of the image sequence. Make sure you check image sequence here to import all the images as a single video file. Drag and drop that video file into create new sequence icon to create an AK sequence. Now play the timelapse. If your timelapse cannot play smoothly, right click on the timelapse and create a 360 proxy. Usually, timelapse does not have 360 meta, so you need to go into sequence setting, projection, ego rectangular, layout, monoscopic, or stereoscopic. Hit OK. Now, if you click on the toggle VR display button, you should see the VR view of this timelapse. It is 8K timelapse, so my computer is struggling to play back smoothly, but we certainly see moving noise and, most importantly, flakers. The noise only happened in low light as this is a long exposure timelapse, but the flicker are very common in 360 timelapse, even in bright daylight with moving clouds. This is extremely bad for VR headset viewing and make your viewers sick. Don't blame Insta360 for it. This happened in any 360 camera or even your 2D camera. The flicker is what set you apart from all the others out there to make your timelapse look professional. Well, why you follow creator up, but not any others? Because your boy Hugh here have massive experience than no other has. And I work hard to make your footage look amazing. Hit the like button of this video and help me to help you better. So there are many ways to denoise and deflicker. For video, you know already, I use neat video. For timelapse though, I use LR timelapse or TLDF. TLDF is a lot easier and faster than LR timelapse. If you want LR timelapse, please refer to this video. TLDF is available both in Mac and PC. The good thing is you don't need Lightroom or any Adobe product to use this. So if you do not own Adobe, this will be a great alternative. Drag and drop all the photo into TLDF. Simply click the flickers and denoise option. Adjust the denoise amount and hit preview to see the result. After you are happy with your result, go ahead and hit render, uncheck output video as this is an 8K video. We use JPEG instead. Choose an output folder and make sure the quality is 100%. Pick JPEG is fine here and hit render. When you import the new image sequence back into Premiere and compare it with the one from the Insta360 Stitcher, you see the flicker is dramatically reduced. If you hide and show the two timelapse, you see what TLDF did in the light. If you are doing daytime timelapse and still want the motion blur of people walking like the one you saw in my Tokyo 360 Sights and Sounds, which now has almost 200,000 views, thank you so much for all the loves. To thank you, here is my secret of creating cinematic motion blur in high shutter speed 360 timelapse. In TLDR, check blend. Blend mode average, number of frame 3 to 5, and opacity 100. It will blend all the hard flickers and moving object to make your timelapse look smooth and beautiful. Thank you for watching another long and in-depth 360 tutorial. Please congratulate yourself because now you are smarter in 360 production than others who did not watch this video all the way through the end. And this technique you can apply today and get the result you are looking for. In the next tutorial, we are going to talk about in a more advanced technique using raw DNG timelapse with both the Insta360 Titan 16-bit capture and the Insta360 Pro 2 right here. I'm also giving out 3 copies of a TLDR software to help you create cinematic 360 timelapse. The way to enter the raffle is to like, share, and comment on this video and the next video on this timelapse series. At the end of this series, I will randomly pick 3 winners. More information to enter is down in the description below. I hope to be you and see you in the next tutorial.
Hey, this is Mark Christopher Lawrence. Go and watch my comedy VR special, the first of its kind. There are no other comedy VR specials. You watch it on this thing. The link is right here. Yeah. Go, watch it. Don't make me come over there. Cut.